Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. I am Kushagra and I am here with another Verilog project, that is RAM ROM memory design, in which I will discuss how to design RAM ROM memory using a Verilog code. And before I can start, I just want to remind you, if you have not subscribed yet, please subscribe as it motivates us a lot to share such more content on it. So firstly, we need to know what is RAM. RAM stands for Random Access Memory, and it is a high-speed device that temporarily stores all the information a device needs for the present and the future use. It is a type of computer memory that can be randomly accessed. Randomly accessed here, it means any byte of a memory can be directly accessed without touching the other bytes. The speed and performance of a system is directly correlated with the amount of RAM installed in it. RAM stores the information a computer is actively using, so it can be accessed quickly. It allows computers to perform everyday tasks such as loading application, browsing the internet, editing a spreadsheet, and switching quickly among all these tasks. And RAM is volatile in nature. Here, volatile means all the data or information stored in it is lost when we will of the power supply to CPU. RAM is made up of small memory chips that form a memory module. RAM is a short-term memory where data is stored as the processor needs it. This is not to be confused with long-term memory that is stored on your hard drive, which stays there even when your computer is turned off. Just suppose you are playing a game from your computer's hard drive or stream a movie from the internet. All of the data that your computer's processor needs to play the game or watch the movie is stored in RAM. This is so that your processor can get to it quickly. Once you are done playing your game or watching your movie and you close it down, the processor does not need that data anymore. So it replaces it with the next task you give it to it. RAM can slow down your computer if there is not enough of it for your processor to perform the task you ask it to do. If your processor wants to load more data than your computer RAM can handle, it has to keep going back to the hard drive or the internet to obtain the information again. So in this video, we will discuss about these two types of RAMs, single port RAM and dual port RAM. Basic difference in single port RAM and dual port RAM is the number of ports. Single port RAM is having one port, and dual port RAM is having two ports. Single port RAM can be accessed at one addresses at one time. Thus, you can read, write only one memory cell during each clock cycle. Whereas in dual port RAM, it has ability to simultaneously read and write different memory cells at different addresses. It is a 64-bit by 8-bit single port RAM. It means we are having 64 locations in a RAM, and at each location we are able to store 8-bit data. It consists of total 5 ports, out of which these 4 are input ports and this is an output port. First, data input port is having 8 bits, as 8-bit data needed to store at one location, and for address input port 6 bits are required, as 6 bits are sufficient to address 2 to the power 6, that is 64 locations. And WE is write enable pin. If it is high, it means we are writing data in a RAM, and if it is low, it means we are reading data from a RAM. CLK is for clock cycle, and Q is for 8-bit output data port. Similarly, we can also design RAM for different sizes. According to your choices, you can change these numbers and play with them. I just want to show you a Verilog code for designing 64-bit by 8-bit single port RAM. So I have used EDA Playground as simulator. Right hand side of this will tell the code about module design, and right hand side will tell the code about test bench of single port RAM. So we have already discussed about these 5 ports. So here the main code begins. So I have used two resistor. First one is RAM for storing 8-bit data at 64 locations, and second one is address register for storing address of that location at which we want to write data or from which we want to read data. That all depends on a mode selected by us. So I have used always block, in which I am checking at each positive edge clock cycle that if WE write enable pin is 1, it means write mode is activated, that input data will store in RAM at address location 80DR, and otherwise it is in read mode. Input address will store in address register, and data at that location will transfer into Q, as Q is a output register. So this is the test bench of this code. Initially we have given clock as 1, and at every 5 unit time cycle we are toggling the clock. We are changing it from 1 to 0 and 0 to 1 again and again at every 5 time unit interval. And initially we have given write enable pin as 1. It means initially it is in write mode. So we are storing data as 1 at location 0. Then we are storing data 2 at location 1. And then we are storing data 3 at location 2. Then we are changing the mode. We are changing it to read mode. Then we are reading data at location 0. Then reading data at location 1. Then reading data at location 2. So I will show this in EP waveform. So this is the EP waveform for single port RAM. So initially up till 30 time unit it is in write mode. Write enable is 1. It is in write mode. It means we are storing data 1 at address location 0. Then we are storing data 2 at address location 1. Then we are storing data 3 at address location 2. Then we have changed its mode to read mode. Then we are checking the data at address location 0. At address location 0 we have stored 1, so it is giving 1 as output. At address location 1 it is giving 2 as output. At address location 2 it is giving 3 as output. Then its mode changed to write mode. Then we are storing data 4 at address location 1. Then it again come into a read mode. Then we are checking data at address location 1. At address location 1 we have stored 4 as data, so it is giving output as 4. So this is about single port RAM. Now I will discuss about dual port RAM. So it is a 64 bit by 8 bit dual port RAM. Main difference from single port RAM, there are two ports here. So we are having two input data ports, and there are two input address ports, two input write enable ports, and two output data ports. Rest everything is same as there was in single port RAM. And in a similar way, we can also design RAM for different sizes. Now I want to show you a Verilog code for designing 64 bit by 8 bit dual port RAM. So here is a code for dual port RAM module design. This is similar as we have discussed in single port RAM. These all are the ports. These are the input ports. These are the input ports, and this is the output port. And in a similar way, we have used RAM register for storing data at these 64 locations. In a single port RAM, we have used one always block. This is a dual port RAM, so we have used two always block that will be written in a similar way, that if writeable pin for port A is 1, it means write mode for port A. In that case, data will store into RAM at address location 88DRA, and if it is in read mode, then data stored at address location 88DRA will transfer into a Q_A, that is output at port A. In a similar way, second always block is written for port B. So this is about RAM module design for dual port RAM, and this is a test bench. This is also quite similar as we have discussed in single port RAM. Initially, both ports, port A and port B, are in a write mode, and we are storing data 33 at location 1 and storing data for 44 at location 2 by using different ports. And again, in a similar way, I can show you this in EP waveform. So this is the waveform for dual port RAM. We are storing at address location 1. We are storing data as 33. At address location 2, we are storing data as 44. And then in second clock cycle, at address location 3, we are storing data as 55. And for port B, it is in read mode. We are reading data at location 1. As we know, we have stored 33 as data at address location 1, then we are getting output as 33 at 10 unit time cycle. Then at 20 unit time cycle, write enable pin for port A is in read mode, and write enable pin for port B is also in read mode. So we are reading data at location 2 and at location 3. For port A at location 2, we are storing data as 44, and for port B, we are getting output as data stored at location 3. At location 3, we have stored data 55, so we are getting data as 55. So this is about dual port RAM. I have discussed about both types of RAM, single port RAM and dual port RAM. Now it is time to discuss about ROM. ROM stands for read only memory. It is a memory device or a storage medium that stores information permanently. It is also the primary memory unit of a computer along with random access memory, RAM. It is called read only memory as we can only able to read the programs and data stored on it, but not able to write on it. It is restricted to reading words that are permanently stored within the unit. Unlike RAM, ROM is non-volatile in nature. It means even after turning off our computer, the contents of ROM will remain same. It will not vanish. Almost every computer comes with a small amount of ROM containing the boot firmware. So this is the block diagram of ROM. It is 8x8 bit ROM. It means this ROM is having 8 locations, and this ROM is able to store 8 bit data at one location. It is containing 4 ports, out of which these 3 ports are input ports, and this is an output port. ADDR is an input port of size 3 bits, as 3 bit is sufficient to locate 2 to the power 3, that is 8 locations. And CLK is for clock cycle. EN is for enable. If it is 1, it means we are able to read the data, otherwise we are not able to read the data. Dout is 8 bit output data port. In the same way, we are able to design for different sizes. Now I want to show you a Verilog code for designing 16 bit by 4 bit ROM. So this is a Verilog code for ROM module design. We are using these three ports and this is an output port. We are using ADDR of 4 bit size as we want to use it for locating 2 to the power 4, that is 16 locations. I have used here memory register of size 4 bits each for 16 locations. And this is an always block that at each positive edge clock, it will check if enable is 1. It means we are able to read data. Then it will transfer the data present at location ADDR into a data. Otherwise, it will send unknown value to data. 4 times x is an unknown value. And then we are storing with memory with initial block. We are storing at 0th location this binary number 0010. And at first location we are storing 0010, and in similar way we are storing all the 16 locations by random values. And here it is a test bench for this code. So we have initially given clock 1, and at each 5 time unit cycle we are toggling it, we are changing it from 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. And initially we have set enable to 0, it means we are not able to read. Then after 10 time interval we are changing enable to 1, then it means we are able to read the data from now onwards. And we have set ADDR to 1010, it means at now we have to read at 10th location. So at 10th location this data is stored, so we will get this data as output. I will show in EP waveform. So this is an EP waveform of this. Initially enable is 0, it means we are not able to read data. So it is showing data output as X, and at 10 time interval we have set enable to 1, then it means we are able to read data. Then it will check at location A is for 10, and so at 10th location we are storing, let me change this to binary. So now it looks better. So at location 1010 means 10, at 10th location we are having 1110. So it is showing 1110 as output. At location 110 means 6, at 6th location we are having 1100. So it is showing 1100. Similarly, you can verify with others also. So this is about the ROM. So this is the end of this video. If you like this video, please like, subscribe and share. And if you are having any queries or doubts regarding this, please post them in comment section below. And thank you.